Hello, everybody, and welcome to the first series of the game for Dreamleague Season 5 League Play. This is Nadas Vinciri, Navi versus Ad Finem, and I'm Sindar, doing an amateur cast of this game. So thanks so much for joining me. I hope you enjoy it. And as the cast draft is underway, we'll get right into it. So far, Navi, very standard opening for them. They've picked up the Beastmaster Chen. That'll be General's Beastmaster in the offlane, as well as Artstyle on the Chen, a classic Navi hero of choice, even with Puppy no longer on the squad. And Ad Finem, they've gone for the Earth Spirit OD. So the scary mid laner du jour for Ad Finem, as well as that pesky, annoying, rotating Earth Spirit. I always like to see Earth Spirit picked up against Navi, because they do emphasize so heavily the early game roam. Chen picked up for that very reason. And Earth Spirit, a hero who really completely capable of fighting those early levels, capable of jumping in, breaking up the gank, potentially getting return kills with that long initiation range of the Rolling Boulder. So, a nice hero. I mean, we saw Navi play Team Spirit in a best of two yesterday in Dream League. And Team Spirit, they also attempted to do early game pressure against Navi, and they didn't execute it as well. So we'll see if Ad Finem can do a little better. Ad Finem, they are in a bit of a role of their own. Navi may have done very well at Star Ladder and two teams yesterday. That was No Diggity in ESL. And then, of course, as I just mentioned, Team Spirit in Dream League. Ad Finem, they're on a bit of a role of their own. They've 2-0'd recently both Polarity and... well, I can't remember the other team off the top of my head, but they're on a decent run themselves, having not dropped a game in four games. So we'll have to see who's got the initiative, who's got the momentum at this point. But it should be a good one. Both teams, a lot of early pressure, a lot of fight, and it should be an exciting game. So the next bans, Navi taking out the Broodmother. That constant lane pressure can really slow their roll when it comes to grouping up and pushing towers. It's very irritating to always have to deal with that on the backside. And not a hero Chen can gank super easily. They've also gone for the Faceless Void ban. And again, something that makes a lot of sense, especially Faceless Void really good in combination with what Ad Finem have on the table so far. And they will go for a Sven next. So immediate Venge pickup from Navi. And this is just textbook. This is exactly the heroes that they love to play. Navi picking up Chen and Venge is just so common at this point. It'll be Sineko on the Vengeful Spirit. And a Darkseer. Okay, so Ad Finem go back for the Sven Darkseer combo. And a combo that, it has to be said, is incredibly powerful. And a little terrifying, but at the same time, not always the easiest to get off. Of course, if you can get that five-man vacuum into a Stormhanner, then you basically win the fight. But getting that off against a Roar, against a Swap, against a Shackle, now that Navi picked up the Windranger for Dendi in the mid, is not always an easy task. So we'll have to see if Ad Finem can manage it. They definitely have the better team fight at this point. With the OD, with the Earth Spirit Magnetize, and the Sven Darkseer, they've got a lot of teamfight power. And so they'll be looking to be online in time to intercept Navi's pushes and take them apart. Sven also a good way with that max cleave build of dealing with the zoo that Navi can bring to the table with the Beastmaster Boars, with the Chen creeps. The question is, can Sven get enough out of the laning stage? Can OD get enough of the laning stage that they will be in position with enough levels and items to contest Navi? Because, I mean, we saw this yesterday against Team Spirit. The lanes were relatively even, back and forth trades, Navi getting a slight edge as far as gold, and then around 10 to 12 minutes, they get the mech on the Chen. They get maybe Necro 1 on the Beastmaster, Focus Fire on the Windranger, and they all group up, and they all push a lane, and at that point on, they're unstoppable. They take two or three towers in a row, they rotate lanes immediately, there's no slowing them down once they get that roll underway. So Ad Finem have a very small window to take control of the game and get their heroes online in order to counter that kind of strat. Now, ad finem, they will have the advantage of knowing this is exactly what's coming. This is Navi's bread and butter. They've played it consistently the last little while. So ad finem will have had the opportunity to study this and think of ways to deal with it. And ad finem now looking for another support. Something with some kind of wave clear might be nice. The Witch Doctor ban from ad finem, really smart. Or from Navi, I should say. That would have been a really nice choice for ad finem, as the cask against the Chen creeps can do a lot to break up that push. It's a 6 second stun on Chen creeps, so nothing to sneeze at. And now,
reserve time, 10 seconds.
Something with wave clear.
Winter
Wyvern, okay, there it is. So,
Navi's turn to pick.
The Arctic Burn, the Splinter Blast can clear up creep waves. It's also really nice. Okay, Lone Druid, the final choice for Navi. That'll be a safe lane Lone Druid, most likely, for Ditchirat. Cold Embrace, nice against this team, though. Whoever the Roar target is, maybe next time, can put under, keep them safe, and it'll save them from the Focus Fire of the Wind Ranger, the damage of the Bear. The question is, will it be enough? But it does synergize really nicely with the rest of their lineup. And Winter's Curse is an amazing spell to have against Lone Druid, because you cast it on him, and his Bear can kill him really easily. So, I like the draft coming out from ad finem. It's stable, it's got a lot of synergy, and it comes online relatively early. The question is, can the Navi roll be stopped? This is exactly what they've been picking for the last week. The early pressure, the incredible timing that these guys can get themselves online. So I really feel like it's on ad finem in the early game here to... Sorry, got to fix my camera controls one sec. It's really going to be on ad finem here to get a lot of the laning stage so that they're ready to go when Navi's push comes. And it looks like we've got a bit of a reconnect happening. We'll go ahead and introduce the teams. On ad finem, it'll be Thug taking the Outworld Devourer towards the mid lane, maybe next time supporting on the Winter Wyvern. It'll be Spartan on the Earth Spirit, Skylark taking the Darkseer to the offlane, and that leaves Madara yet to connect in on the Sven. On the Dire side, it'll be Artstyle playing his classic Chen General on the offlane, Beastmaster Ditchira taking the Lone Druid to the safe lane. It'll be Sineko supporting on that Vengeful Spirit, and finally, Dendimon himself taking the Wind Ranger to the mid lane. And it'll be a Wind Ranger against OD matchup, which is slightly Wind Ranger favored, at least for the early levels. Before OD gets those early points up in Arcane Orb, the damage from Wind Ranger is slightly better. The attack animation is slightly better, slightly faster. And of course, Wind Run to negate any early damage. They do have decent heroes for ganking the Wind Ranger, though. Both maybe next time and Spartan. Maybe next time with the slow, Spartan with the Roland. They can potentially catch the Wind Ranger out. But at the same time, Dendi himself is going to have backup from Artstyle, who will be sending creeps to the mid lane. The OD, a hero they won't want to have a great early game, as that hero really can slow their pushes. One big ult over the top can really wreck a lot of these heroes. So look for Artstyle to be active. This is not a guy who farms his Chen, who disappears into the jungle and comes back later with early items but no contribution. He gets active, and he gets active early. And sometimes to his own detriment. And if it doesn't work out, then maybe ad finem have a chance to be in place to stop the death ball and to stop the push. But with that said, we're into the game. Finally unpaused. And guys, thank you so much for joining me. I'm Sindar. It's just an amateur cast. So make sure to switch over to the mainstream to catch all the intermediary things that they'll be doing over at Dreamleague. All the interviews. All the fun. Red Button and whatever else Slacks gets himself up to. But for the games, I'll be practicing. So feel free to join me. And now we've got an early smoke from Madara. The rest of... Oh, they roll him up onto the high ground. He may catch out Dendi here. Iron Shell on. He's trying to body block, and he's going to make it. Dendi should be your first blood here. No. The wind run comes out. Still alive. Sineko there is backup, and Dendi will survive the gank. Salves up. So, nice attempt. A little unfortunate that he was standing there on the high ground. If they'd managed to get the smoke uphill and hadn't had it broken, then maybe they might have had more time to get prepared for that gank and finish Dendi off. But as it is, he saved the skill point, skills up, and now Dendi in general looking around the backside. They want to trade for this. Maybe next time. Going to be slowed by the boar. He could fall here, getting very, very low. The stun is there for Madara. Well played. General still looking for it. He's got the hawk vision, but maybe next time into the trees. So, aggression for aggression will be countered so far. And one rune each to the mid laners. So, despite all that aggression, ends up being a one for one. And things will stabilize for now. Hey, Illumini, you should hop in for game 2. If you're still around. So, as far as these lanes go, Skylark going to be able to put out a decent amount of pressure early onto the Lone Druid just because of the force of those Iron Shells. Now, Sineko is here, but there's not a whole lot he can do against the Darkseer, especially if Spartan spends any kind of time up here. Okay. Hold on just 1 second, guys. I'm going to get a co-caster in here, just so I don't have to talk for 40 minutes straight. I'm just waiting to make sure there's not going to be any action. And I'm going to... Illumini, just hop into Discord with me. 1 sec, guys. Hopefully I don't miss anything important. Hey, man, how's it going?
Well, it's going great, thanks. So, I'm in the game, ready to go.
Awesome. So, I didn't miss anything, no first blood, which is a little surprising, given that it's Navi versus Ad Finem.
Well, Usper is probably going to go downtown.
Oh, yeah, there he is. Just got back in time to catch that one. So, Sineko will draw first blood against the Earthshaker. He was trying to disrupt the pull, it looks like, but Navi did rotate the Chen, and with that net...
It's definitely worth it, yeah.
Yeah. And now so immediate smoke coming out from Navi, rotating towards the mid lane. And an Invis rune as well on Sineko, that's handy. They may be able to catch the OD here. Thug out a little too far.
Oh, they don't have mana for stun ready.
Oh no. Okay, that's what he's waiting for. There's the Shackle. Nice dead. Shackle connects. That's gonna be a dead Thug, no problem at all. The Shackle probably not even needed, but the fact that they get it just makes it so easy for them to get that.
Yeah. Really well played by them. I like it.
So did you get a chance to catch much of the draft?
Not really. I tried out OBS Studio and was casting one of the ESL games as kind of mock thing.
Oh, okay.
Quick look at the draft. Looks like standard. The AF lineup, they drafted the Sven Darkseer combo yesterday as well. I watched one of their games, so it looks like they just love that combo.
Who did they play against in that series?
Let me remember it. I think it was... I have to quick open the last game.
That's all good.
Brain's not working that well. Oh, it was Team Spirit, of course. Team Spirit.
Oh, okay.
And they kind of... they had a little mind game as well. They picked Nio, and... Team Spirit was scared of the CK, and they picked it for themselves, and then AF just went for the full AoE combo with Sven as well as Darkseer and rolled over them. Alright, top lane, I think there's some action happening.
Yeah, it looks like General getting, or Skylark getting dived here, will be caught out yet again. No, not again, it was the Earth Spirit who went down earlier, but, well, Art Style again with the rotation. And I mean, this is what we expect to see from his Chen. He is not a Chen who sits and farms. He is a Chen who gets active. And so far, it's been very effective for them, finding them 3 kills.
Yeah, it looks like he's gonna pick up some arcanes as well. He already has boots, he has 900 more gold. Yeah, that means he can do a lot more, you know, test faith. That's a really mana cost intense spell.
Yeah. Now, the good thing for Ad Finem is that Madara is getting free farm here. General has been forced off the lane, he's back in the jungle farming up. He has found his level 3, but this Sven is getting complete free farm. And I really feel like Sven is kind of the linchpin of the Ad Finem draft here. They need him online early enough to counter the Navi push that will be coming come the 12 to 15 minute mark.
Oh yeah, definitely. And I would actually love to see some more points in Stormhammer. I know it's not popular at all, but it definitely helps when you have to deep push against a ton of creeps. You know, that stun deals also up to 325 damage. That's a decent nuke against the push.
Yeah. Well, and I mean, I understand why he's going for the cleave, because there are going to be a lot of creeps, but you're right. Like, if the creeps are grouped up, the stun does hit in an AoE and can do a lot of damage in its own right. And it's burst damage.
I guess they have a Winter Wyvern as well. Splinter Blast is also pretty decent spell for deep pushing.
Mm-hmm.
So, I guess it's fine.
So far as CS trades go, Sven is taking the advantage over the Lone Druid. The Lone Druid has been involved in 2 kills, though. And other than that, Dendi's Windranger holding even with Thug, but Thug gets the Astral off. The roll's going to be there. Going to just miss the timing on it, unfortunately. The stun will be there to follow up, but Windranger's out. Nice double shackle. Spartan could be in trouble now. He's going to fall. And they lined up. You can't do that against Dendi. We'll get a pick. And on the same time, the Darkseer goes down in the offlane yet again. He has really been punished.
Probably didn't expect it. The thing is, Dendi went for max shackle shot build, and you usually max out the power shot.
Oh, that's right. Gunner. Wow. 4 points. And only one in power shot. I can't remember ever having seen this build before. That's incredible.
But, I mean, it's strong. It's a really long stun when you hit it.
Well, and that's the thing, right? It's if you hit it. It's so situational, because if you miss, then it's useless. But, I mean, Dendi, he hits his shackles.
Yeah, I mean, when you're secure that you're able to outplay the enemy, I mean, they have the Vengeful Spirit, so, you know, they have some setup.
Yeah, absolutely.
Even the Beastmaster Roar at some point.
Mm-hmm. And, I mean, Ad Finem, they've got heroes that are going to want to be close in the mix. They've got the Earth Spirit who's going to be rolling in. They've got the Sven who's going to be jumping in. So there are melee heroes that are going to be close together in the fight for Dendi to target that on.
Yeah, definitely.
And Sven not going to have an early BKB, most likely. I mean, most Svens we see now, they rush probably the Blink and the Sanjin Yasha before they go for that, so.
Yeah, and the Helm of Dominator to stack up Ancients.
Yeah, which is already online, so really nice timing on that for Madara.
Yeah, so Lone Druid, does he have his Midas finished already? Yeah, of course. Already off cooldown almost again. So, yeah. He has some good form. Slowly building towards his Radiance.
Another smoke rotation coming in from Sineko and Artstyle. They'll block out the camp. So no more stacking for the Sven. And now Thug could be in trouble. Will he get caught? Does have an Invis. A little unfortunate for Navi is...
he was also staying in a really good position. Like, yeah. Most ganks come from the top side of the river, and he was standing down to the bottom.
Yeah, and maybe next time positions himself on the cliff, so he spots Artstyle and Sineko trying to rotate onto the top lane, too, so that won't work. They did at least get this sentry down, so the camp will be blocked, no more stacking. There's already a pretty decent-sized stack there, though, so...
Yeah, it's a triple stack, and I mean... In the earlier stages of the game, it's hard to take down too many agents at once. So, I guess it's somewhat okay.
Yeah, yeah.
He's gonna pop the guard string, and yeah, there you go.
And everyone just kind of sitting around the area. They don't want Navi to be able to contest this at all. And maybe next time we'll get some nice levels out of this. Already almost level 6 all of a sudden.
Yeah, definitely. That's usually the problem with the support, that you're stuffed in terms of levels. Can't do enough in team fights.
Yeah, absolutely. And that early Winter's Curse will be pretty huge this game, as, again, they are against a team that's going to want to group as 5. And, I mean...
Yeah, and later on they have the Vacuum Winter's Curse set up, so really nice team fight combination.
Absolutely. And you get that if the Lone Druid's Baron is in the neighborhood too. There's just so much damage.
Yeah, I think the only problem might be that it's a teamfight heavy lineup and you somewhat have to hit those spells and get something out of it. And if you don't, like, you're screwed.
Exactly. I mean, theoretically, the vacuum into Sven Cleave combo is unstoppable, but it is really hard at this level of Dota to land those as effectively as you want. So it really is going to be down on Ad Finem to execute properly once Navi go for these early pushes.
Yeah, it's always a little bit easier to get the 5-man Echo Slam in a 2k pop.
Yeah, and then you're like, this here is amazing. Why don't all the pros play it? Well, it's a little easier to counter.
They do play it. At least they have played them for quite some time.
Yeah. Another smoke.
Yeah.
Seneko and Artstyle rotating to the bot lane this time. The roar setup is there, but this is General just trying to stay alive. Spartan got the roll in. And now Adfinna may not be expecting the counter gank.
Oh,
nice silence.
Silence is there, but yeah, he had no rolling boulder still on cooldown.
A little unfortunate, but amazing reaction time from there. The smoke broke, and before Seneku could even get the stun out, the silence was there. So really nice play from him. It does still mean he's down. He didn't manage to save himself. And Navi will be able to claim a tier 1 tower off this, as Artstyle rotated in with the creeps. And it goes down so fast.
Yeah, that's the thing. Like, you get some champ creeps, and they all get the free attack creep from the inner beast aura. That's, like, so insanely great.
Yeah, and I mean, here it is, 10 minutes, 42 seconds. This is the Navi timing that we've seen so much recently over the course of Star Ladder, of course, their games yesterday. And they'll just rotate from lane to lane at this point, and unless Ad Finem can stop them.
They're gonna take Roshan now, I guess. There we go with Omni.
And there is this ward here. So Ad Finem may have an idea, and they are rotating over. But it goes down so fast. Yeah, and the Hawk is there scouting this.
That's the mech money as well for Chen, so
that's huge. Yeah. And Dendi, what build is he going for? It looks like it will be the Maelstrom Rush. He's got the Gloves of Haze picked up. Another 1,300 gold, so getting quite close to it. And, I mean, we take a peek at the net worth, despite how even the last hits are. And Sven is out front as far as net worth, but the next three, Lone Druid, the Windranger, and the Chen. So Navi in good shape for their push, and they're rotating top lane now. Could catch up Madara. This would be a big kill. The Shackle, gonna be off the mark.
I mean, he tried to go for it. I mean, you can't miss. You're gonna miss every hook you don't throw, right?
Yeah, yeah.
That's what Dandy said, and he's gonna throw Shackles as well.
And I'm actually surprised it didn't latch. There's so many trees in that area. I figured he had a pretty good shot at it. Just a little unfortunate. The question is, are Ad Finem in a situation to repel the push? They've got Winter's Curse online. They've also got Magnetize online at a pretty decent time, too. And Skylark does not have Vol yet. No points in Vacuum, no points in Wall. Skylark has been shut down quite hard here, actually. He's sitting near the bottom of the net worth chart. This is very unusual for a Darkseer. Especially,
they don't even have a single set of arcane boots on the team, and that's like the most important thing. Winter Wyvern needs to be able to spam out the Splinter of Blast, and they cost a lot of mana, so you need at least two sets of arcanes on your team to be able to repel pushes.
Absolutely. And look at this, Chen creeps in the bot lane, pushing in solo, while the rest of the team goes top. They'll be summoned back now just as Madara comes to clean them up. And now he's at a position to defend this tier 1. Does have a TP. But the Hawk?
They can't really defend.
Nope.
Like, they need the Winter Wyvern Splinter Blast to be there, you know? He can stay safe while he throws that thing out.
Yeah. They need to be set up before Navi gets there. And now they're trying to split push in the mid lane. And they get the tower down to about half health. So Dendi will TP back to defend it. They will still lose the top, and they will hold their own mid, so nice rotation from Dendi, realizing they don't need him there, and General scouting out the movement.
General, maybe? Oh, they can see Seneca at least with a ward, so...
Yeah. This could be a trap. Navi, though, they have the Hawk. Does help a lot in these situations.
So at least they spotted out the ward placement.
Yeah. So none of Navi will be caught. It's 6-0 now, 14 minutes in, two towers down, and the net worth lead starting to get out of control. It's hitting about 5k, And as Navi continue to knock down towers, that's only going to get worse.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
And the OD at this point is not keeping up.
The problem with OD is you need to be constantly fighting to have high intelligence to deal huge amounts of damage, but you're not fighting right now. And you're just getting pushed without really being able to walk in. Like, when you walk into that army, you're just gonna get roared and killed.
Yeah. Now, Denny with a double damage rune as well. Focus fire on this tower is gonna break it down extremely quickly, with the bear already Sacred Relic online for this lone druid.
And yeah, I guess there's no
roar
way to stop
connects onto maybe next time. The power shot from Denny finishes him off. That was an incredibly easy kill, and now with him down, they can take the tier 2.
Yeah, he has his arcanes, but now he can't use them. They pop the necrobook as well, and tier 2 is going to drop really quick.
And that's a 15-minute. That's a 15-minute Midas and Radiance on the lone druid.
If they want, they could even probably just keep pushing, but they're going to play it safe. Get the other outer towers and... Yeah.
Now, Denny could be in trouble here, but he is shackled up Madara. Still taking a lot of damage from the right clicks of Thug, and now Thug. Swap is available, if they have the range for it. They just getting to it. He's going to cancel the TP. There it is. And Thug kills off Denny, but that's just the Aegis, and he will pay with his life.
One thing I didn't like about Odie's play there was when Windrunner uses Windrun, like, you don't really have any more damage for the hero, since when stun was already committed, you could have just Astral Imprisonmented him, you know, so that he can't run back to safety while Windrun is going, and then you finish him off as soon as it's done.
Yeah. Well, maybe a little misplay. Maybe, I mean, Navi did rotate a lot of heroes up there very, very quickly, so I'm not sure there was a whole lot they actually could have done at that point. But Chen does fall in the river. That's the first pick of the game for Ad Finem. So at least there's something. But it really does feel like... I mean, this strategy of Navi, it has served them incredibly well over the past week. They went so far at Star Ladder with this exact play. Now, while we got a bit of a lull in the action, I got to ask you, do you think that this dominance from Navi can last once another patch comes out, once these heroes are changed up a bit? Or are they really a one-trick pony? Do they have anything else up their sleeve? Because, I mean, this is working for now, but it won't work forever.
The thing is, like, many teams resort to this strategy right now. Just the full-on five-man pushing lineup with you not being able to defend since you don't have the D-push to do it. And this has been around for quite some time, so I think the general pushing will get nerfed a little bit. And the other thing is, when you play against guys that outscale you in terms of raw skill, they're not going to win your lanes. And then the problem is the enemy team can push while you have problems defending. And then just the whole game plan flips over and you're the one losing without being able to do anything.
Mm-hmm. Well, here comes the push once again. Bot lane, like clockwork, one lane to the next. Towers falling left and right. 17 minutes in. And we're already about to lose the second to last tier 2 of the game for Ad Finem. And they have not had a single chance to use their team fight. There is now finally 2 points up in vacuum as well as a point in wall, and Skylark has the mech online. So maybe Ad Finem...
And he just used the vacuum to farm some creeps.
Oh dear, Skylark could get caught out here. The roar is available. Is it going to be in range? Not quite. And a nice kick from the Ear Spirit will hold them back.
The thing is, AF is not grouped up right now. Like, OD's missing.
Yeah, and he needs to come back. Yeah, they need everyone here to defend this.
Earthbird's feeding the boss slow right now. Mm-hmm. 40% slow for free, and it's even magic immunity piercing for some reason.
Yeah, and now Necrobook 3 online for the Beastmaster, as well as the blink up on Dendi for those easier shackles.
Is Odie dead? Oh yeah, I guess.
Bogus fire is there, but the stun from Madara, the Wave of Terror, does not quite connect, and they've got the Warcry as well, so Thug and Madara looks like they will be able to get away. Navi on hot pursuit. Dendi blinking forward, may be able to find Thug. Does he have a TP? He does, but after what happened last time, not wanting to use it this close to the enemy heroes, Looks like he will get away.
He would need another blink, but I guess he can...
Wind run forward. Didn't he blink? Shackle will not latch. The swap is there on the Earth Spirit. They'll claim him instead. Yeah, the stun will connect and Spartan will fall. So they do find one pick at least. And oh, what do you know? They're set up in the exact lane they want to be pushing, as there is a tier 2. They've got the creep wave with them. Oh, man. Radiant's top tower is under attack. And I mean, Skylark, he's got the blink online now, so Skylark has caught up impressively. He's just been desperately trying to farm, and this is exactly the item that they need to defend. So I think from Ad Finem, the plan is we give up our outer towers, we count on Navi to make a mistake on high ground. If they get a team wipe, then they are back in this game. It'll be a hard to come back from there still. They are very far behind in terms of gold, but a lot of that is towers. So if they can get a good team wipe and get a tier 1 or 2 down across the map, then they are back in this. So I feel like they're really, really relying on getting that combo off.
Oh yeah, they definitely are. Like, Chen's not even farming that well. He only got another Oak Club. Wait, is there something on the courier? Oh, okay. Never mind. He has a Staff of Wizardry, a Blade of Alacrity as well. So that's almost an Aghanim Scepter for Chen. I was like surprised. How did that guy get an Arcane and Mag that fast? He just has an Oak Club after like 8 more minutes. But yeah, he almost has his axe now.
Yeah. Well,
okay,
and there,
so Chen's pretty farmed.
There is a smoke rotation coming up from Ad Finem, though. They are desperate to make something happen. They don't want the push to come. They want to get a pick off first. They smoke into the only place on the map where they have vision. But unfortunately, none of Navi is anywhere nearby. They're all in the bot lane. And it looks like this smoke...
Yeah, they're waiting for the next rush.
Yeah, this smoke's going to be off the mark. Now, Ad Finem may be able to backstab them, coming from a direction that Navi may not expect, but...
Yeah, the smoke already ran out.
Yeah.
They can't really do anything. They get down at least one board, so they might be able to find a smoke pickoff somewhat later on. But right now, they can't really get anything.
Well, and the thing is that their vision is deep in Navi's woods, and I don't think Navi have any intention of playing on their own side of the map. They're going to be looking to be on Ad Finem's side for the rest of the game, more or less, once this Roche goes down.
Yeah, but the other thing is like Navi's gonna ward all the places where they actually are in danger, so you somewhat have to ward places where they aren't.
Now Roche will spawn, and General just so patient. He sat in that pit for a good minute and a half waiting on the Roche, because they wanted to take it as soon as it was available. And they will.
I mean, he pretty much already has everything he needs. He has maxed out Boar, maxed out Aura, as well as a Necro 3. Like, when you have that as a Beastmaster, you're happy.
Yeah.
And you're ready to end the game.
Yeah, and Dichirat on the Lone Druid has his Vlads up, as well as the Radiance on the Bear and the Plate Mail. So this Bear, incredibly hard to deal with at this point in the game. Later on, it does fall off, but for now, with that kind of armor, it is incredibly hard to bring down, even with the Sven and Thug, so... Navi have all their tools, and they're heading down mid lane.
Yeah, I guess they're just gonna brute force the high ground right now, and I'm surprised already they're TPing back at least one hero. Like, they have to go back right now. I can understand that they somewhat want to get the tier 2, because it's really, really low. Alright, okay, but I just thought Norway would brute force down mid lane without a rush, but I guess they just want to get a pick up first.
Well, actually, this is what we've seen a lot from Navi over the last little while. They're not as greedy as they used to be, as Ditya will get the deny. They do focus on pushing, but they don't all in anymore. They take their time, they sit back, they counter any push, they get all the lanes pushed out, and despite being an early game focused team, as Shackle, oh, Dendi gets stunned up though, brought down, Aegis down immediately. The damage from Madara is very intense right now, but Aurora on the backside catches Skylark. General may fall here, though. He is silenced up. Magnetize connects as well, but the Bear is in the picture now, and the Radiance is burning down these supports. Maybe next time takes so much damage. A stun from Seneca will finish it off, and now on the backside, blink away from the Darks here, but they're chasing Spartan. Shackle will connect, and Dendi will finish him off. So quick two heroes down, neither of them with buyback. 30 seconds in the grave, and Navi in position to push.
Yeah, they used the Magnetize as well, so that's down for a minute. I guess they're just going to brute force it now. Problem might be that Neko won't be up for the push, so... Oh, they're not going for it. Are they?
I think they are. Just...
Oh, It was just a bear going to the secret shop, buying some stuff.
Yeah. And that bear with a hyperstone as well now at 24 minutes in. And look how fast this tower falls. Now there's the Ag Scepter for the Chen as well. Link forward from Midar. Nice back wall! But the stun only connects on one, and the ODL does absolutely nothing. Now Skylark will instantly fall. No, healed up. No, the power shot will finish him off. Dendi on a killing spree, and Spartan trying to get the roll away, but Sinego blinks forward to stop him. Swaps for it, actually. Now the save from there is there from the Astral, and Sinego getting low. Thug doing what he can. The stun will come out, but the all heal is there from Chen. On the backside, Midar gets the stun onto Dendi, holding the bear in place, but it is just so tanky at this point. And they've committed everything they had. Navi still healthy, and the melee racks will fall.
The problem is OD has 5 stolen intelligence right now. That's why the ultimate did absolutely nothing. I was surprised. I thought the game plan was to vacuum wall, then immediately Winter's Curse, give the OD some time to right click enemies. I mean, he's not dealing damage, but he's gonna steal end during that time. And then follow it up with a Sven Stun Cleave. And, you know, then you had like 6 seconds to hit enemies, at least build up a little bit of intelligence, and then drop the hammer.
Was the Winter Wyvern up, though, when that happened? Maybe she was still dead. Because it was 30 seconds. I think she was still dead, unfortunately. And, I mean, the vac wall was there. And, I mean, the problem is, the OD was... He really felt forced to push the ult. He didn't have time to wait. They were all in position. And so he kind of felt he had to commit it. But
the thing is, it did nothing. Yeah. And it always does nothing when you have no stolen intelligence. Like, that's how you have to play that hero now.
Now, Ad Finem, they're trying to get some trade here. They are grouped up, realizing they just can't sit back and let Navi do what they want. But with the bear here, they're chasing forward. Shackle will connect onto Midara, and now General with the roar on him. Maybe next time, not going to be able to save his carry. Midara pops his BKB, trying to get on a hero, and General on the backside getting very, very low. The stun will be there, and they will bring him down. But on the backside, Spartan has got the magnetized out, but he will fall. That's a dominating spree for Dendi, and it does end up being a 2-for-1, but roar went out, and the Necrobooks are up. So Beastmaster not necessarily required. The inner Beast aura is nice. But Navi, can they backdoor this? They can.
I guess they just want to wait for creeps. The thing is, Necrobook deal a lot of damage, but I think they're not enough on their own.
Well, I don't know. Dichira, he thinks he can do this. The glyph is forced out. And
I guess Navi's happy with that.
Yeah. The glyph being down means that they can take their time. Anytime in the next 5 minutes that they go, they should be able to take another lane of racks, unless Ad Finem find the perfect team fight. And I really feel like they need to smoke at this point. They need to find a pickoff. Midar are going to try and clean up the Chen creeps. Not going to do so.
They're definitely going to have to do the desperation smoke.
Yeah. And the thing is, I mean, despite the fact that they're quite behind, Sven is massively farmed. And Skylark, the other hero who needs to be huge, has found the mech, the blink, and the arcanes. So they have some of the tools they need to take this fight. It just all depends on the execution. And, oh, with Dendi picking up a BKB, things get a lot harder.
Oh,
Navi swap up onto the Earth Spirit, who will get roared up. The Cold Embrace is there, but the bear is on him. Now, Thug blinks forward. The vac wall is... No, no wall. Just back onto two. But the Sven Stun comes out. Shackle, though, onto Skylark. Gonna bring him down. Nice Winter's Curse, actually. And the mech is there. Skylark's still alive. And now Sven cleaving through the wall. The ODL connects. They're gonna bring Dichira down, it looks like. And now on the backside... Well, they will lose the Sven, they will lose the Darkseer, and all they cleaned up was the bear at that point. But they may get more. Artstyle gonna fall. Thug gonna trade his own life for it, though. So a 4-for-2. And the thing is, with the Beastmaster still up, with Dendi still up, they can still push this. They don't need to wait for the Lone Druid and the Chen to be back. The Chen creeps are still here. They're gonna rotate to top tower.
Yeah, like, the team fight synergy, it wasn't really there. They kind of threw their spells out without getting the maximum out of it. And when you're behind that much, you need to get the maximum.
Yeah. And Dendi gets rolled on. Vacuum is there. The silence, the magnetize. But a shackle will connect, and Sinego will fall on the backside. So they find him, and they may catch Dendi too. He does not have an Aegis at this point. Astraled up. And will go down. So they clean up a couple.
Really nice pickoffs.
Yeah, they did lose their tier 3. And Navi maybe getting a little too overeager. with two of their heroes in the grave. But I mean,
the thing is, OD has 3.5k gold right now, so he can buy out a good item, maybe mystic stuff, so that his ult deals more damage.
I think he needs a BKB. I mean, it's not the best item for him at this point, but I think he needs it. Because if he dies, he's already bought back, blew the buyback
and
for that
The problem is Navi doesn't have problems with physical damage either.
That's true. With the Lone Druid Bear, he just needs it for the lockdown, though. More for the damage.
As well as Necro units, they deal a ton of damage as well.
Yeah, I know. I mean, it's really desperation time for AF. They just need to get anything they can. And they're going to group up. They're going to leave their base. Top wave is pushing for now, so they're going to try and get a tower out of this. And Madara pops God Strength, maybe a little early for that.
It's just going to work out now, I guess.
Yeah. Yeah, that's it. Oh, look at this. Lone Druid picks up a Medallion of Courage. So that's not an item you see on the bear, but just that extra more physical damage.
Well, you can use the Solar Crest on the bear, you know, just to tank him up even more, giving tons of armor as well as the juicy evasion.
Yeah, exactly.
And well, at some point, you know, when the bear stacked up, you can just give it to the Lone Druid and he uses it on the bear every time.
Mm-hmm. Well, and here comes the push. And they don't even need to commit heroes. They can just sit the bear on the high ground. They've got the swap to save it if it gets gone on. The Astral's there. Maybe next time we'll get stunned up, though. Shackle, not even needed. Cold Embrace is going to save him for now. And they will get the stun out on Dendi. Roll forward, completely off the mark, but nice Winter's Curse. Is it going to be enough, though? The wall is there. Thug doing what he can with the right clicks. The OD ult, not enough damage, and now the bear's on him. He's got a back. Artstyle going for the Sven. Astral to save Thug, and the buildings are falling. Madara gets the stun off on the Sineko, who will fall. No, save four staff forward, and now Madara get a fall. He does not have buyback. 72 seconds, and the lane of Rax has fallen. That is almost certainly game with two lanes down, 67 on your Sven. Navi's just taken out game one. 30 minutes, but a very decisive victory. 6-20 is your score for now. Advent not done just yet. They're going to continue to try and fight this, but Thug, Shackle on two. That's GG. Well, a very clean, quick game from Navi, executing their game plan exactly as intended. And, I mean, Ad Finem, there were some signs of life there. And I really thought they maybe had a potential counter to the push. But it just... Navi's push comes online so fast. What do you do? What do you do when it's there at 12 minutes?
Yeah, you have to get the ultimate deep push. Not only Winter Wyvern, but maybe even drafting just a Caudle to blast the wave away and say, all right, your stuff's dead. Come back later.
Well, and the problem with the Caudle, though, is...
Of course, I forgot it. Shadow Fiend. When you hit the raises on the creeps, you can kill them so fast.
Yeah. It is a risky pick, given how easy it is to dominate mid these days. But we'll see. Game 2 coming up soon, folks. We'll have to see if Ad Finem can find another draft that can stop what we know is going to be coming from Na'Vi. So come back in a few. We'll catch you then, and see you in a bit.